Hey, what's up? It's the daft piece of shit of YouTube here, and this is what you're looking at here is my setup. Now I figured I'd do a setup tour. It's been a long, I wouldn't say a long time, but it's been a while since I've done one. And I don't really like doing these because basically all it is just me saying, "Oh, I've got this shit, and this shit, and fuck you." That's basically the entire video. Honestly, like I don't know, I didn't really want to do one. But I felt like that I should because my setup changed quite a lot. And yeah, it's probably the last one I'll do in probably, I don't even know how long, but I probably won't change this stuff for a long time. Yeah, I don't really like doing these videos, but fuck it, I'll do it anyway. Because, you know, more of that YouTube revenue, you know what I'm, am I right, guys?
Ah, fuck, I'm fucking shot!
No, but seriously, yeah, figured I'd just do a setup tour just... because I really haven't got much any videos this week, and actually this video has to be out tonight, so it is Sunday as of recording this. But yeah, so I figured I'd do a setup tour just to show you guys what's changed and the way this place is laid out now. As you can see, this stuff is, well, not new to the setup, but it's, you know, this used to be on its own area, now it's on the desk. And I have, you know, a new desk here. But yeah, let's get into it. I'm just gonna, you know the way this shit goes. I just go around telling you what shit I have, and yeah, that's it. That's really it.
Let's get right into the nigger.
So we'll start off here. It's this is just full of clothes and shit. Actually, in fact, these two drawers here are actually broken because this thing is just an old piece of fucking trash. Like, literally, there's no bottoms on these drawers because this thing is literally older than me, and it fucking sucks. So, and I do have a better one. I've had a better one for like 3 years, but it needs to be fucking varnished, and yeah, it's buried somewhere in the garage now because, you know, fucking haven't gone around to doing that yet. Was supposed to do it back in 2013, and it's now nearly the end of 2016, so I don't think I'll ever get that done. But yeah, on top of that, we just got this fucking, I don't even want this here. It's a printer, obviously. As you can tell by that flashing red light, it's low on ink, and I couldn't give a fuck about it because I don't even want it, to be honest. But my parents use it, so it has to go through my computer to work. Fuck this thing. Seriously, I don't like printers at all. Here we have some games. This is just games for my older systems as well as PC games. So we have some PSP games here, original Xbox, I only have a few of those. PlayStation 2, got some PlayStation games, and then the rest of these are PC games. So older PC games that I use on the secondary machine, ones that, you know, aren't on Steam, obviously. Some of the games for Windows, games from back in the day, and some older PC games. Here we have my PSP 3000. I got this back in like 2009. As you can see, it's a Gran Turismo edition PSP. I love this thing, honestly, but I don't play it as much as I used to, just because, well, I just don't really go enough places to really where a handheld console is necessary anymore. Got some spare RAM here. It's just lying around. Usually I keep this in a bag in my closet, but this is stuff that I've recently, I say, was probably about a month ago. It's been sitting there because I'm lazy, but this kit of RAM's dead. I tested it. It's old SD PC 133. I think one's a 256 and one's a 512. I tested these and they used to work, but apparently they don't because sitting in a bag for years apparently breaks shit. So yeah, and this kit of DDR2 here, it's a 4GB kit. Used to be in the XP rig, but you know, I took it out, and when I put the new motherboard in that a couple weeks ago now. It's a bed where I slay all the pussy, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, I get all that pussy, you know, a fat fucking snowman nerd like me gets all the pussy, you know what I'm saying? That's what chicks are into these days, you know? I'm completely fucking joking, like, literally, this is the best place because I can sleep and I don't have to deal with people's bullshit. So, because, yeah, I just, yeah, fuck everybody, you know what I'm saying? Nah, I'm kidding. I don't get enough sleep, I wish I could be there more. Next to it, just got some random shit. Just got an old 80s clock radio here. My mother bought this back in like 1981. It's a realistic, you know, AM/FM clock radio. I don't use the radio part because, well, there's only one radio station that's around here and they just play shit music, just like top 40 shit, and that's, I don't like that shit at all. Yeah, it's garbage, so I just use it as a clock. It's pretty cool too. I like the wood grain. It's a vacuum fluorescent, I think. But yeah, really nice. I like it. And of course, I have my phone charger here as well. This is just where my phone sits when I'm charging it. So on top of it, I just got my wallet, which has no money in it. as always, because I'm fucking poor. And I'm not poor, I'm just broke. And there's my Surface Pro pen. I don't know why that's doing there. And there's a little stand. It's actually for my Wii U, but I use it as like a phone stand. This stuff's all sitting on top of a couple of things I made back when I was in high school. This wooden stool here I made about 6 years ago when I was in 8th grade. And this wooden drawer here. This is a drawer, it's just got random shit in there. Just odds and ends. With other shit, just adapters and stuff. I made that when I was in 9th grade. Here we have some tissues which are used for fapping. Oh, no. Well, of course, you know, like, if you, like, fucking lie and say that you don't fap, like, you're a liar. Like, honestly, everyone faps, everyone watches porn, so, you know, you're a liar if you don't fap, you know, if you say that you don't fap. Bottle of water, because, yeah, as much as of a fat piece of shit I am, you know, sometimes I just get sick of that and I like to actually have water. There's my Surface Pro. It's a, you know, tablet PC. I've had this for a while. It runs Windows 10. It's running the insider builds of Windows 10, actually. I just use it as a bedside machine for, you know, you guessed it, watching porn. And, not just porn, but, you know, sometimes I find it hard to get to sleep, so I like to have something playing, whatever the fuck, just usually YouTube. Just like to have playing, and then, you know, then I can fall asleep, so. Here's the meat and potatoes that are set up. The, where all the quote, work gets done, even though no work gets done here. It's my main setup. So I have my machine, my main PC here, which I do all my gaming on, and I do gaming, video editing, all that shit there, and then I have my game consoles here, at least the relevant ones, the more modern ones, here. My chair here, it's designed, this chair, I forget what this is called. I got it a few months ago. I forget what they're called, but it's designed to be similar to like a racing chair. It's not really, it looks a lot more worn out than it is. I guess mine was defective because when I put it together, like this was all wrinkled up. So it looks like a, you know, like a fat piece of shit's been sitting in there for like 7 years, but no, that hasn't been true. I only got this like back in like February or March or whatever. I don't even remember now, but yeah, really love this chair. It's great. Armrests fold up like this. So, you know, if I don't want them, I don't have to have them, but I like them there. So there we go. Came in different colors. You can get them in red, blue, and white. I got the white one because, honestly, I didn't really want any colors. I wanted it to sort of be monotone. Here is the computer. This is my my PC that I built. Well, it's using the same case I've had for like 3 years, but I rebuilt the machine this year because, well, my old shit died. So it has an Intel E5 Xeon. It's the Intel Xeon E5 2670, which is a 2.66. It's a 2.6 gigahertz, 8-core. CPU, LGA 2011. It has 16 gigs of RAM. It has a 500 gig Samsung SSD. I think it's the 850 Evo. Has a terabyte drive and a 2 terabyte drive, and Radeon 7850 graphics card, and it's an ASRock X79 Extreme 6 motherboard. Great machine. Love this thing. And yeah, got a Blu-ray drive. The case is the Bitphoenix Shinobi. Because I do get a lot of people asking me what case I have, and the Bitphoenix Shinobi, they don't make it anymore. It's a bit of an older case, but they don't make it anymore, so, you know, whatever. But yeah, love my PC. I really didn't want to have to rebuild it this year, because basically that's when all my money went down the fucking toilet, but, you know, my old Z77 build died, so I had to rebuild, and I decided to just go X79, because why the hell not? Here we have my two smartphones, and yeah, oh my god, he has two smartphones! No, not really, I only keep one active, which is my Android phone, but it's a Sony Xperia Z5. Absolutely love this thing, it's a great phone, love it, and, you know, I don't really care too much about phones these days, but, you know, this thing's absolutely fantastic, you should get one. And my other phone here is a Windows phone. My Lumia 640, which is my previous phone, yeah. So, you know, I'm a Windows and Android guy, so, you know, gotta have them both. So what's connected to my PC? We have two Acer K24 2HL 24-inch monitors, both 1080p, 60 hertz. Really love this setup. Yeah, both 1080p 60Hz. I think they're 3 millisecond response time. I don't remember, but it's something, you know, decent. So, you know, that they're really good monitors for the price I paid for them. Like, these, they were cheap, and but they're, you know, good for the price. So, you know, absolutely like them, really do. And you know, 24-inch, 224s, you know, perfect size. I mean, don't really need anything bigger, to be honest. My keyboard is fantastic. It is a DAS keyboard, Professional Model S, with Cherry MX Blue switches. As you can see there, Cherry MX Blues. And, great keyboard. Absolutely love it. Once you go mechanical, you don't ever go back. So, you know, if you're serious about typing or gaming or anything, you know, just everyone should have a mechanical keyboard. I don't care who you are, you should have one. Just rubber domes should just go by the wayside. They're not necessary. My mouse is a Logitech G502 Proteus Spectrum. Really love this thing, mostly because of its ergonomics. Like, I really love the way it feels in the hand.
Fuck! 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 Oh!
You know, I never used to be, you know, a fan of mice that had a lot of buttons on them, but honestly, I really do like this one because, you know, it has, I've got two, like, it's got back and forward, and two other buttons here, which I've got actually got set to zoom in and zoom out because, you know, as you guys know, I'm blind, so, you know, I'm a blind piece of shit, so, yeah. Also, I love the scroll wheel on this. It just scroll, you can either scroll normally, or if you press this button here, you have like the infinite scroll, whatever, the smooth scroll thing. So you can like scroll through like long Excel documents or whatever. So yeah, it's also RGB, it's got RGB LED in there, and you can change it to any color you want. I just have it as blue. Speakers are just a couple of Logitech 2.1 speakers. I forget the model number of them. I've had them for years now, and yeah, they're okay speakers. I'm not much of an audiophile, so. Headphones are just an old pair of Sennheiser HD205s. They're very worn out, but I've had these for a while. I should get some new headphones eventually, but these still work just fine. So, like, they look like they've been, they look like shit, but, you know, they honestly, they're fine. They sound really good, at least to me anyway. I'm not much of an audiophile, but Sennheiser headphones are generally pretty good anyways. For the webcam is a Microsoft LiveCam HD3000, just a cheap $20 webcam, so, you know, but it does the job. It's 720p, so, you know, it's good enough for me. And my game controller is an Xbox One controller. This is, well, what was specifically the Windows version, even though it's exactly the same as a regular Xbox One controller. It's like the original one that doesn't have the headphone jack, so, but that's fine. I really don't care about that, so. But yeah, that's the main setup. That's where all the videos get created on this PC right here. It's fantastic, so it runs Windows 10. Yeah, it's great. So the resto gaming setup here. We have the TV is a JVC 32-inch 1080p TV. Now 32's, you know, kind of small, but you know, because I have it on the desk here now, it's actually just fine because I'm sitting right in front of it, so I really don't need anything bigger than this. Anyway, but this is a really nice TV too. It's got a really good picture. And it's like the colors are nice and vibrant on this. So they don't look like as vibrant on camera, but you know, it's a really nice TV. I absolutely like it. Really do. 1080p is, like, fine. Honestly, I don't need 4K. Especially because all I hook up is game consoles, and this thing can't even do fucking 4K anyway, so, you know, I don't really care about 4K. But yeah, the consoles we have hooked up, we have my Nintendo Wii U. This doesn't get as much use these days, which is kind of unfortunate because the games on the Wii U are fantastic, but, you know, it's just, there's not enough of them. Like, yeah, I don't know, I've played all the ones I've got, and, you know, they were great, but there's just not enough continuous games on the Wii U to, you know, keep me engaged with the system, so it usually just sits for ages, and honestly, there's no more really games, good games coming out for it until the new console NX comes out, so, you know, fuck the Wii U. I don't know, I've thought about maybe selling it off recently, but, because I just don't play it anymore, really, as much as I'd like to. We have my Xbox One here. This is a 1TB Xbox One, the original one, obviously. It's what's currently on right now. But yeah, Xbox One, it's got a terabyte hard drive. It's great. Love the Xbox One. Now, I know a lot of the, you know, people are going to say, oh, all the games are coming to PC anyways. Yeah, I know that. Like, I know Gears of War 4 and Forza Horizon 3 are both on Xbox One and PC, but Honestly, I like the Xbox One as a media device anyways. This thing works excellent as a media player, like, as a media device, so... That's not the only thing I use it for, I mean, I play games, so... And depending on what game it is, I'd either get it on PC or Xbox. So, like, Gears of on Xbox and Forza Horizon, I'm getting on PC, so... Yeah. But yeah, like the Xbox One a lot, I really do. Got the controller, you know, it's a newer controller that came with it, it's got the headphone jack, so... But yeah, Xbox One. Other consoles here, got the, my original PlayStation 3, I've had this since, like, fucking 2008. And, yeah, PlayStation 3, it's an 80 gig one. It's starting to have a bit of problems now. It actually does yellow light quite often, so it does give any yellow light of death fairly often now. If I try and boot it up, it'll just randomly shut off. So it does take, like, say, 3 or 4 times a lot. Like, most of the time it's okay, but then, like, every once in a while it'll just randomly yellow light of death, and it's been happening a lot more lately, so I might have to look into that and try and fix it. And next to it we have the Xbox 360, which ironically works perfectly fine compared to the PlayStation, so... But this is it's a Xbox 360 Elite. It's actually got the biggest hard drive I think these have. These had a... I think the biggest one you can get was a 250 gig drive, and that's what this one has. So, this is a... Yeah, it's... This one was manufactured in 2010, so it is one of the newer, like, 360s, so it doesn't have red ring problems. So, yeah, but 360 Elite, so... Got this really cheap a while ago, so never really showed it, but yeah, have a 360 now, been playing through some games on there. Here we have more games, so these are the rest of my, you know, physical games, because, you know, obviously I have Steam on the PC, as well as the games I showed you earlier, but these are the rest of my physical games. So I have all my Xbox One games there, Wii and Wii U games, and below here we have PS3 and 360. So there we go, more games obviously will come, so, but... is currently what I have right now, so, yeah. I wish I had a proper solution to store all my games in just one spot, but I can't fit them all here. And, yeah, I'd like to have, like, a shelf above my desk, you know, just to have all my games. Here's the secondary setup I have. This setup is basically what I like to call my workbench. But I keep my secondary PC on here. So, yeah, this is basically my workbench. And what used to be here was an old TV stand and, you know, my filing cabinet, which is still there, but, you know, I decided to move all my TV stuff to the desk there and then use this as a workbench, because I was sick of scuffing up this desk, with working on stuff all the time, like, because I work on computers and shit like that, because, you know, I'm just a fucking nerd. But anyways, so yeah, this is just I got this desk for, like, oh, it's not really a desk, more of a table, I got it for, like, $20, solid wood. Unlike that, which is just chipboard, but this is solid wood. Right now I've just got my secondary PC, the XP rig, set up on here, which this is my secondary gaming PC. I use it for playing the older stuff that really doesn't run well on Windows 10, so... Or really any modern versions of Windows, so it runs Windows XP, which runs a lot of the older games. PC's actually kind of a bit new for XP, honestly. It's a Core 2 Duo E6700 with 4 gigs of RAM and a 8800 GTX graphics card. It's really more of a Vista machine, but, you know, runs XP because, you know, I like it. Peripherals I got hooked up is my IBM Model M, my IBM Model M 13 keyboard. Absolutely fucking brilliant, you know. Like, Model M's are, like, the best keyboard, like, you could ever use. Mouse is just an old Microsoft mouse, nothing special. Monitor is nothing special, again, just a 17-inch, 1280 by 1024 monitor. It's honestly just a piece of shit. Doesn't even have DVI, and so I have to use a fucking adapter to hook it up to that 8800 GTX, because that's DVI only, that card, so... But yeah, it's a VGA-only fucking piece of shit monitor, but, you know, I don't want to have a widescreen hooked up to this, because a lot of the older games don't support widescreen resolution, so they look like shit. Yeah, a lot of widescreen monitors don't scale properly, and the, NVIDIA software for the card doesn't scale properly either, so, you know, you can't really keep stuff at its native aspect ratio unless you have a monitor that scales right, and I don't really have any that don't. Speakers are just a cheap pair of Logitech fucking USB-powered speakers, whatever, I don't really care. And the controller is just a wired Xbox 360 controller, so, yeah, there we go. I love this system, and I love this setup too. If I need to work on something, I can just shovel this shit back. And then, you know, work on something. When I did the motherboard upgrade on this, I worked, this is the first sort of project I worked on this table here. you know, I don't care if I scuff this up. You know, it was only $20 and it was already scuffed up anyway, so as you can see, some of the fucking paint there is missing, so. Underneath the desk, we just have my, just a backpack there with my laptop in it. And, there's just another computer I'm gonna get rid of, my old media center machine, which I don't use anymore. And there's my filing cabinet, which just has a really disorganized drawer. This drawer used to be organized, holy shit, like, I just have random shit in here. There's my Wii U gamepad, because I use the thing so much, it sits in the drawer. And, just chargers and cables and some old phones, you know. And here I just have more shit, junk food, basically, and fucking random controllers and shit like that, so, yeah. There's an old scanner sitting on top of it, which I don't use, it's my dad's. But, you know, for whatever reason, he's too much of an idiot to keep stuff in his own space, so he just fucking piles everything in here, so. I tell him not to do that, too, and he just does it anyway. Here we have the closet, so, in here. This is where all my shit is. I have so much crap, to be honest. Like, lots of shit. I have way too much shit. So, up the top, we just have, I used to be into collecting model cars years ago. These are some of the nicer ones I kept. I would honestly, like, if I had more space, I'd probably put them on display, because I do like some of the ones I have. I just don't have any room to put them, so they just say, those have literally been sitting there ever since I moved in here, like, 3 years ago. I also like older cameras and stuff, too. Like, you know, just, these were, like, older cameras that were either given to me or just old ones that I used to use. There's an old Handycam, and there's an old Polaroid that my grandfather gave me. There's a Sony Mavica floppy camera that a friend of mine gave me. So, it literally uses a floppy disk, which is pretty cool. And that shit's gonna fall down. A bunch of tapes, which I need to digitalize, actually. That's another reason why I keep this thing. This old computer, because it has a capture card in it, which, so I can digitalize. I need to digitalize some of those tapes there, because I have, like, shit my grandfather recorded on, like, 20 years ago. There's an old film SLR, and there's a whole bunch of point-and-shoot digital cameras, and there's, like, about 5 or 6 of them there, so, like, all throughout the years. Thinking, like, the oldest ones from, like, 2000. But, yeah, there we go. There's the box of my power supply up there, and just a bunch of other shit. Down here, we just have more shit. My older game consoles, my Xbox, my PS2, my N64. I'd like to have these hooked up somewhere, but honestly, they look like garbage on that TV, because I'd like to have them all hooked up to an old CRT, because, you know, I love these older consoles. These are my shit, fam. Like, seriously. Love these things, but, you know, don't have the room to hook them up anymore. Got a bunch of packing materials from shit that I've bought, but, you know, I need to sell off a few of my computers I have lying around, so, yeah, I'm just keeping some packing material and stuff, you know, whenever I need to ship shit. Got a couple of empty cardboard boxes that these consoles are sitting on. There's another one behind this one, so, of just shit I've bought over the years. More shit. It's some old software here, boxed old Microsoft software, and there's a copy of OS2. Old copies of Office, Flight Sim 95, as well as Windows XP. Oh. Fuck.
Fucking degenerate.
Well, we all knew that was gonna fucking happen, so, yeah, rip. But yeah, underneath, in these containers here is just more shit, like, literally just computer parts and cables and, other, like, optical discs and old software and shit like that in there. And I have, like, more fucking monitors and shit there. Like, they're just all crap and it's just random shit. That's all it is. This side of the closet, we have, more random shit. We just have, boxes for stuff and, like, boxes for all my shit. Because I keep all my shit. And there's, like, behind this one. It's like behind my Xbox One box, and there's more boxes of shit that I don't even have anymore. I need to clean this place out. There's an old motherboard that I don't even... I think the board's still in there, but it doesn't work, so... You know, well, it does, but I broke it because I'm a fucking moron. More shit is some personal documents and stuff up there, and, you know, receipts and shit for shit I've bought. Down here is just clothes and all kinds of shit. So just clothes and stuff, in these bags here is all my, like, spare, like, is all, like, different laptops and shit, like, some of them I want to get rid of, You know, I have some, like, old vintage laptops in this bottom one, like, I have that old Toshiba Satellite, and, you know, I sure need to make videos on sometime. But then there's other laptops, you know, I've just had and I don't even need and I want to get rid of. There's my Lona laptop underneath this. It's a Dell Precision. It's a Dell Precision M4300, so it's the one I loan out to people whenever they need a computer. It's just a spare machine, so, you know, that's why it sits out, doesn't sit in a bag. Well, because I don't have another bag for it. That's why, actually. I have more computers. I have that, my Vectra Pentium 3 thing. Pentium 3 HP Vectra, as well as my AT custom build there. These don't really get much use, so they just sit. If I need them, I'll pull them out, but yeah. And more just computer parts and other shit. So it's just shit. That's all that's in there. It's just shit. Shit that no one cares about, and that no one should care about, because it's shit. So that's a room setup for, September 2016, and I just realized today is 9/11. Literally, not even joking, today is 9/11. If my camera would focus. Actually, I'm not even gonna bother try to focus on that. As you can see, it is 9/11. So, you know what that means.
Allahu Akbar!
I came! I'm triggered.
Yeah, so, I don't know, why is, like, whenever I make a video, why is today always something ridiculous? Either it's some day that's a coincidence with something that's a meme, like today, which is 9/11. Even though 9/11 really shouldn't be something that we joke about, but people do because we're all fucked in the head. Or, like, you know, it's fucking 420, you know? Like, why is every video I make on some fucking weird day? Like, Jesus Christ. Anyways, so that's my, yeah, it's a setup tour for September 2016, so I don't know, probably won't do one of these for fucking long time, because I don't really change my stuff that often. And basically all this video is just me saying, I have shit, if you don't have this shit, fuck you. Like, that's really all it is, and I don't really want it to be that way, but that's just the way people fucking take this, because, you know, the internet is just full of morons. Like, I'm not like, the people that watch my videos and care about them, you know, you guys aren't morons, but, you know, the majority of people, believe it or not, are stupid. Like, that's just the way it is. Anyways, thank you all for watching, and be sure to destroy the fucking like button, or don't, I don't care. And yeah, see you guys later.